My name is Max. Welcome to the PiCockpit tour. With PiCockpit, you can easily control and monitor your Raspberry Pi using a web browser. It's free for up to 5 Raspberry Pis. Let's log in and get started with the tour. It's very easy to add a new Pi to PiCockpit. We have a video that shows you how to do it. After you add one or more Pis to your account, you will be able to see all of them in PiCockpit. You can see which Pi is online and which are offline. You can also see the IP addresses of your Raspberry Pi, the public IP and the private ones. Your Pis can be located anywhere in the world. As long as they have an internet connection, you can access them with PiCockpit. Click on the heartbeat icons to see important stats in real time. For example, your Raspberry Pi's processor temperature. Click on the Raspberry Pi to get to the apps that make up PiCockpit. Currently, we have 6 apps: GPIO, PiControl, PiDoctor, PiStats, BME688 Ammeter, and CO2 sensor. Let's have a look at PiStats first. Here you can see more stats of your Raspberry Pi, for example, the CPU usage. To see the stat over time, which you're interested in, for example, the SOC temperature, click on the Show Me button next to it. This is just the temperature of Raspberry Pi's CPU. With sliders next to the graph, we can adjust the data range. For example, you see here that it's oscillating between 45 and, well, somewhere about, let's say, 47 degrees centigrade. That is because it's currently having a very low CPU utilization. This plot is very helpful, for example, to see if your Raspberry Pi is overheating during operation, and a heatsink or a different case would be a good idea. Next, I'll show you PiControl. PiControl comes with 3 useful core commands buttons to be able to turn off your Pi, reboot it, or update the PiCockpit client. Of course, you can also create your own commands, which you can then run from the web interface at the push of a button. Details can be found in our help. PiDoctor is currently the most powerful app in PiCockpit. You can use it to run an extensive array of tests on your Raspberry Pi to learn more about it and check up on its health. Click on Run All Tests to run all the tests. It does what it says. In the WLAN module, you can see the WLAN networks around your Pi, including their strength. The network module shows you the IP addresses and network interfaces that are active on your Raspberry Pi. This is a good start for diagnosing network problems. The system module provides a lot of information about your Pi. It is very handy for diagnosing problems with undervoltage and overheating. You can also see how much free space is available on your Pi and where your Raspberry Pi was manufactured, the model, the revision, RAM, processor, and so on. For example, here we can see that I have a Raspberry Pi 4 on which PiCockpit client is running with a revision 1.1 and 1 GB of RAM. The video module and the USB module show you your connected screens and USB devices. The software module shows you which processes are currently running and how they are utilizing the Raspberry Pi. Now let's take a look at the GPIO app. The GPIO app makes it really easy to read the state of your Raspberry Pi's GPIO pins and control them. To add a new pin, just select it from the drop-down menu and click Add. You will see the pin state immediately. Use the Configure button to make further settings. A Amongst other things, you can change the names of a pin and the states. For example, a GPIO pin that indicates the state of a cat flap, open or closed, can be named correctly, and you can see that at a glance. The GPIO output has a toggle switch with which the pin can be turned on and off. If you don't need a pin anymore, you can remove it from PiCockpit using the Remove button. The settings will of course be preserved even after you close the browser window. A special highlight is the software PWM section. Here you have a slider for the GPIO pins. For example, you can use this to dim an LED continuously. The next two apps make it very easy for you to read two different sensors. The BME688 air meter app is compatible with the popular Bosch BME680 and BME688 sensor chips. It allows you to easily read humidity, temperature, air pressure and many other values. The IAQ or air quality index lets you know when opening the window to let in fresh air would be a good idea. Of course, it is also possible to view these values over time. If you don't have a BME688 breakout board yet, but would like to purchase one, we have linked a board from us and a board from Pimaruni for you in the setup dialog. You don't need any drivers, and you don't have to install any additional software. Everything is already integrated in PiCockpit. The CO2 sensor app works in just the same way. It supports a sensor called EE895. This is a very precise sensor that measures CO2 in a double beam process. Again, we have linked a plug-and-play breakout board for you in the setup dialog. Too high CO2 values can lead to headaches, tiredness and concentration problems. Again, a high CO2 value is an indication when it's time to open your windows. Now that we are done with the tour, it's time to shut down the Raspberry Pi. To do this, we go into PiControl and click on Power Off. As you can see, a warning dialog comes up where we have to confirm the power off first, which protects you from accidental clicks. Little details like this dialog all add up and help to make PiCockpit easy, safe and fun to use. Thank you for joining us on this tour today. If you have any problems or requests, or if you would like to use more than 5 Raspberry Pis, please contact us at support@pi3g.com. We are here for you. We wish you a lot of fun with PiCockpit.